Qualcomm's newest chip will connect to 5G high-speed data services that will bring faster download speeds and speedier connections. I sat down with Qualcomm President Cristiano Amon for an exclusive interview ahead of MWC to talk about the company's latest moves into the technology.
One of the big announcements we made at the show, we're very proud of it, is the Qualcomm 5G POWERSAVE technology. And that is actually a technology that is allowing the first generation 5G phones to allow you to have an all-day battery life. We have a very mature smartphone base today. Users won't settle for any less than what you have on your phones today. And I think that's the bar for those new 5G flagships. And we're happy of a number of OEMs announced phones at this show with this technology.
Now, isn't it really the carriers that decide how and when 5G happens? And are they really on board for a rapid launch?
Yeah, Emily, this is a great question. I'll do a comparison because I think sometimes we forget about what happened in 4G. When we were about this time launching 4G technology, that was about over a decade ago, we had two operators and four devices. Look at where we are right now. We have 20 operators, 30 devices. It's an order of magnitude different. Actually, it's a proxy about how much faster 5G is going to get deployed.
So talk to me about this partnership with Samsung that you've engaged in. They've now announced a flip phone. Will a new gadget like that help accelerate this?
I feel that there's enormous potential for 5G to change the form factor of devices. We're very proud of this partnership with Samsung and how they have been a great partner, pioneer in new technology with us. We also seeing a number of different devices being announced, and we see a potential for form factors to change. The most important thing is, as you change your experience with 5G, you're going to want a different type of device and a different type of screen size and resolution, and the apps are going to become way more powerful, which will actually have a more powerful hardware that goes along with it.
So you think it's not the form factor that's going to accelerate 5G, it's 5G that's going to change the form factor?
Yes.
And what kind of form factors do you see?
I think we will start to see, bigger screens are here to stay. I think you will see the opportunity for larger screens as you have flexible OLED technology. You're also going to see devices that are more specialized for more capable gaming, because 5G will allow you to have mainstream gaming on 5G devices. And also you're going to see devices that are going to converge between productivity. Now, over time, we expect to see virtual reality or augmented reality devices, as well as a companion to your phone, that are going to be using 5G technology, and we hope them to look like eyeglasses.
Now, other companies coming out with 5G, Xiaomi, OnePlus, they've got their own 5G plans. How worried are you about the competition?
Not worried. All the 5G launches announced at the show, with probably exception of one device, all of them are using Qualcomm technology.
So, and what about Huawei? Is that the one?
Look, when we look, we always been competing with Huawei, but as also a customer of Qualcomm. But the most important thing, when we think about China in general, I like to put it within that context. China mobile ecosystem see 5G as an opportunity for them to expand, not only in China, but globally. And we see Xiaomi, Oppo, OnePlus, Vivo, and a number of other companies actually embracing 5G and going to Europe markets, even in the case of OnePlus, going to United States markets. So we think our China business will continue to expand, and 5G will be a great opportunity for that.
Huawei is facing bans on its networking equipment around the world, the UK in particular, an interesting one to watch. How closely are you following the Huawei situation?
It's not really the business that we're in. I think our infrastructure play, it's in the small cell, especially as we think about densifying 5G networks. So we're not directly related, but Huawei is a partner on the infrastructure as we do interoperability. I think it's a sign that, if anything, this whole discussion is a sign that 5G is now way beyond mobile. It's going to become a critical infrastructure because it's going to power everything around us.